Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and this is my fourth video and talking about my favorite characters in video games. And this video, we're going to be talking about Metal Gear Solid 2. The previous video was on Metal Gear Solid 3, and I picked a female character, so you can definitely expect this video to be about a male character, which isn't that hard to do. Metal Gear Solid 2 had a lot of male characters to pick from. A lot of very interesting and weirdly and unique ones, but I feel like my choice is a little too safe, maybe. It's not a crazy unique character. It's actually also a playable character, Solid Snake. So this is my first time in this series actually picking a playable character as a favorite character. That I feel like, to me, that's kind of rare. It kind of makes sense, though. I mean, you don't play as him for 80% of the game. Or more, it feels like. So maybe that has a lot to do with it. Actually, it does, because I like him when I'm not playing as him. Because it allows me to see Solid Snake from a different perspective. When I'm playing as him, like his strength, his abilities are very limited, you know, because of the control scheme, the schematics, and things like that. But I really think that was the intention of Hideo Kojima. Kojima wanted to show Solid Snake no longer as a rookie, but as an expert. You know, because in Metal Gear Solid, he's still learning things and figuring things out. This is like the third time he's been manipulated. Is it the second time? I don't think he was as manipulated in Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake. But this is the second, you know, Metal Gear Solid 1 was a second time he was really totally manipulated. But it was done in such a way that's just like, whoa, like, and he comes to grip with the fact that the main villain in Metal Gear Solid 1 that he was fighting against was his twin brother, Liquid Snake. So that totally made him, like, just rookie, totally unaware of the whole situation, of what was going on. He was the only person in that Alaskan base who didn't know anything. Even Liquid Snake mentions that, poor fool, you're the only one who doesn't know. You know, that's a quote from the Metal Gear Solid. So he doesn't know anything in Metal Gear Solid 1, so we relate to him. But I think Metal Gear Solid 2, he's finally broken out of that role. He's no longer the person that doesn't know anything. That's Raiden now. And it makes sense. We get to see Solid Snake as self-aware, as kind of not disclosing his personal motives, he being mysterious, even taking on a different whole persona, being Iroquois Plissken, disguising himself in new outfits. It's very interesting to see, and it's really, I loved that character transformation, seeing him develop. One of my favorite moments in Metal Gear Solid 2 is when you finally meet up with Solid Snake and he has his bandana, and you meet up with him as Raiden, and it's a gameplay moment. I'm fighting alongside him, I look to the side of the screen, of the gameplay screen, and just like Solid Snake is just kicking ass. Like, he's shooting that M4 like crazy, with crazy accuracy, and enemies are just going down and down and down. It was amazing. I love that moment of seeing, like, Solid Snake is a total badass. If Solid Snake was a playable character, we would not be able to witness that, like, that way. Just because the nature of Metal Gear Solid 2 is a stealth action game. You're controlling Raiden with the same, you know, it's not like Snake has different animations. The amazing thing about all Kojima games is that the characters that you play as, even in the cutscenes, they pretty much do the same movements. For example, and this is switching to a different game, Metal Gear Solid 4, you don't have a button to make Snake jump. Snake can't jump in gameplay. Well, look at all the cutscenes of MGS4, Snake never jumps. Well, I mean, he kind of rolls, but rolling is actually able to do on the gameplay. But in none of the cutscenes, he, like, physically actually just, like, jumps. You know that cutscene where he has to go up over all these containers? He kind of, you know, just goes over the container like he does in the gameplay scene. So that's amazing. Metal Gear Solid 2, same, of course, it's the same concept because it's pretty cool. But same thing, like, Solid Snake doesn't have different animations. He doesn't do any crazy wild thing while you're playing alongside him. He still has the same movements as you do when you're controlling Raiden. But he's amazing. And Raiden, you're playing with him, you're not as amazing. And you can be if you're really good, but not as amazing. And just seeing the badassery of Solid Snake just made me really, you know, made me really like that. I thought that was really awesome. And, you know, he's just cool, badass character. I just really came to really like Solid Snake in that game. Not to say there are, I feel like, I don't know why I gravitate towards Solid Snake in this game, because, like I said, there's so many other interesting characters in MGS2. Solid Snake is certainly interesting. Banff? Oh my god, he's interesting. Like, one of the most unique characters ever. And, Fat Man is definitely an interesting character. Just the madman psycho with, you know, an alter ego of Peter Stillman. Emma, oh man, I was really heartbroken when that scene with Emma. That was quite a scene. And Otacon, his past is finally revealed. Definitely interesting. Ocelot with the lick. So yeah, Metal Gear Solid 2, as any other Metal Gear Solid game, tons of crazy cast of characters. It's pretty amazing. I have no idea why I feel like it's hard for me to justify Solid Snake here, because he's not as unique or interesting here, but I think a part of it is because I was so attached to Metal Gear Solid 1. So I really grew attached to Solid Snake. And just seeing him in a totally different role, he's aware, he's showing you where to go, and things like that, it's so awesome. Who's the most important character in MGS2 is a question that I haven't even addressed yet. That's a tough one. I would have to still say Ocelot. I feel like Ocelot is the one that pretty much orchestrates the entire thing. So that's, you know, definitely Ocelot there. Raiden is definitely an important character simply because of the ties he has with Solid Snake. Solid Snake, kind of important, but his role, I think, is not as important as someone like Ocelot, or even Raiden for that matter. Really great cast of characters. The only character that I really did not like was Rosemary, because she's just really annoying. I liked Raiden, actually. I liked him questioning everything and just being confused, and I liked his past. The fact that he was a child soldier in the past with the link to all this, that was a really interesting twist in the character development. I like that. Rosemary is the one character that really just really bothered me. Really annoying. If Rosemary did not exist in Metal Gear Solid 2, I think that would have made the game a lot better, actually. That would have been pretty cool. And Roy Campbell. God, such an interesting character in MGS2 for... Yeah, MGS2 has such amazing cast of characters. So interesting. But I'm playing it safe. I'm picking Solid Snake. He's definitely my favorite character in MGS2. He's definitely one of my favorite characters in the gaming world, period. Simply because he's the character that I really grew to playing as in so many Metal Gear Solid games. And I love Metal Gear Solid as a franchise. It's just pretty much one of my, if not the favorite, game franchise, you know. So those are my thoughts. Who is your favorite character from Metal Gear Solid 2, if you played it? If you haven't, or whatever, I don't know. But what is your thoughts on that? Let me know. Next video, since this I talked about a male character, will definitely be a female character.